Yeah, do you guys do delivery?
Oh, I'm sorry, we don't have enough demand for it yet, but no, we don't have it right now.
Well, but do you think you can hop in your little Scion and deliver it to my house?
Oh, I'm sorry, I don't have enough staff to delivery.
Well, we'll make enough staff. I mean, come on.
Yeah, but not today, though.
I think you have enough. I think you have enough. I think you just don't like me because I'm white.
No.
Put me on with manager. I'm not laughing.
No, I'm the owner here. Yeah,
oh,
I'm
you're the owner?
Yes, I'm the owner. I don't have enough staff.
Well, can you put me on with man? Please, with husband. Can you put me on with your husband or one of your, like, 10,000 children? Please?
Okay, let me just talk to my husband. Is that nice?
Hello, can I help you?
Oh, yeah, I'd like to place an order for me to pick up.
Okay.
Yeah. Do you guys have General Tso's chicken?
General Tso's chicken?
Yeah.
No.
Fuck.
Hello, Peter?
Yeah, I'd like to do a takeout.
You want to pick up or delivery?
Delivery, if you can.
Address?
My address? Yeah, I'll just like that.
Okay.
That's it.
That's it, right? All right, thank you.
But wait.
Yes.
Do you guys have General Tso's chicken?
No, we don't have that, no.
Do you guys have cream of mushroom soup?
Sweet and sour. How about sweet and sour chicken on rice?
No, do you guys have cream of mushroom soup?
I'm sorry?
Do you guys have cream of mushroom soup?
No, we don't know.
Do you guys have, like, a statue of Buddha?
No, we don't have that, no.
God. What do you have?
I'm sorry?
You have a number 23 extra big bowl of beef?
Yes. Okay.
Do you guys have the fook chicken?
I'm sorry?
The fook chicken?
A what?
The fook chicken.
Oh, I cannot hear your phone. I'm sorry.
Here, I'll call back. I'll call back and complete my order. Just cancel it. I'll call back in like 10 minutes when I actually have a decent phone.
Yeah, get a decent phone.
Yeah, get a decent phone there, douche.
Hello,
yeah? Yeah, were you the one that said I have a shitty phone?
No, it's a static phone.
No, I'm 100% sure you said you have a shitty phone.
Static phone.
And you were like, dude, I have an LG phone, okay? Your Chinese people made it. It's not a shitty phone.
I didn't say shitty phone. Come on, I'm not that stupid to say shitty phone. I'm very educated. Come on.
You told me to go fuck myself, dude. That's what you basically
I'm
told me.
I'm very educated. Come on, you educated man yourself, but I don't
that's
because
I'm white. That is because I'm
know.
White.
I'm
that's
sorry?
Why I'm educated because I'm white. It comes
know,
with
white,
it comes with being white.
You want a Buddha, something Buddha. Why don't you go buy a Buddha and then you will say you want some kind of Buddha? I don't know.
Well, do you
white
guys have a Buddha?
Don't believe in Buddha. Come on.
Well,
common sense. You a Catholic or a religious?
Shouldn't
you
be doing
people,
something worthwhile, like
come
working
on.
For AT&T or something? I heard they have a lot of jobs for people like you there.
I'm sorry. White people. Why were you asking for
did
Buddha?
Did you go to Harvard? Did you go to Harvard?
I don't go to Harvard. If I go to Harvard, I wouldn't listen to your phone.
You wouldn't listen to my phone. That's right. You'd be, you know, you'd be doing the high up Chinese jobs, like, you know, working.
Hey, listen. I'm busy, and then I'm sorry, but
your mom's
we
busy.
Don't have the
Buddha
that you're looking for.
Do you like schoolgirls?
Hello.
I like schoolgirls. Do you like schoolgirls?
You like girls?
No.
I don't like girls.
What? You're gay?
I'm a girl. I don't like girls.
You're a girl. I can...
Yes.
Do you want to go on a date? You and me?
How high are you?
You'll hire me?
How tall are you?
I'm 6'2".
Oh, I'm only 4-1, but you're too tall for me.
Oh, well, I can crush you.
You're too tall for me, man.
We make good babies. We make good sex.
Fun show featuring OMG. It's fun, it's a show, and it's also free. We'll take some calls, make some pranks, it'll be real swell. So keep your preferred streaming client locked till we say farewell. PLA and Cacti Radio, please rep it for life. We got some drunks and Canadians, it's out of sight. It's time to start the show, so I'll shut the fuck up. And here's where I say the fun show, yay. It is really fun, I'm not just saying that.
I hope you can hear me, because I did not do any preparation. I hope everyone can hear me.
Stacy, who the fuck's Stacy?
I don't know. How are you doing, Brad Carter?
I'm fine. Don't use my real name, because people don't know what it is.
That's not your real name.
Did you ever give an official announcement that you're changing your name to Stacy? Did I miss it?
Yes, I am changing my name to Stacy. That will be my third name change.
Ew.
Hi, Akison.
Hi.
How are you tonight, dear?
Oh, I'm okay.
Are you going to stand me up again? Or are we going to meet next weekend?
I'll bring you flowers or something. Just ship them in the mail.
It's just not that easy anymore to be a predator, is it, Roxy?
No.
I'm sure there's some price I have to pay for those flowers. All right, guys. I don't have any announcements at all. Does anybody have any sort of announcements? I don't... There's nothing...
I have one.
Okay.
Actually, I don't have one. Never mind.
Why'd you let Akison on the show?
I don't know.
Stacy.
I don't know. I'm going to edit out where you said my name.
I'm sorry.
That's what I'm going to do.
Wait, so why are you changing it again? I mean,
because OMG,
what did OMG
stupid,
Hacks do?
It was a stupid name, and I just named myself after the website because I didn't know what else to do because I'm really uncreative and boring.
Stacy's so much better.
Yeah, I like the name Stacy. It's just hard to start calling you that because we've just known you as other things for so long.
That's okay. We're going to call
Thanks for calling the Hilton Los Angeles
Airport.
We'll
get used to it.
If you would like to make or change sleeping room reservations.
Oh, just take over, Brad. Why don't you?
Huh?
Nothing. I don't understand what you guys are going to say, so you guys go first.
So it's just going to be
at the airport.
Speak up.
Hello?
Speak up. I can barely hear you.
Hilton Los Angeles Airport.
Adjust your headset so that the microphone is right next to your mouth.
Yeah. Can you hear me now?
Is it... Yeah. We're in a room upstairs. We're staying here right now, and we got this kind of a problem.
Go ahead, sir.
Okay, don't be a smartass. So we got a swimming pool. We brought one of those swimming pools, those inflatable pools from Walmart. A 12-foot diameter, and we had it filled up, and it just broke.
I'm sorry, sir. You're breaking up.
You know what, sir? You suck. Goodbye. Okay. Fuck that.
I'm sorry. Hey. I could barely even hear him.
It wasn't you. It was him. He was just really bad. Hi, Pseudo.
Hi.
Hi, Pseudo.
I hope that...
Hi.
People can if people can't hear us, I'm gonna have to start hanging up. So, oh my gosh, the governor of Hawaii. The governor of Hawaii. His last name.
What?
The governor of Hawaii's name is Abercrombie.
That's
Neil
weird.
Abercrombie.
Is that what kind of name is that? Like what nationality?
I have no idea, but it's like Abercrombie and Fitch. It's really weird.
Yeah. Yeah, that's just the only thing I know that name from.
That's crazy.
Yeah,
I thought it was a fake name.
What the hell? Where'd that come from, Roxy? Did you just...
I saw it. I typed in Hawaii, and I saw Governor Abercrombie. I'm like, what?
Aloha, and thank you for calling the Grand Waikiki and Suites by Hilton Grand Vacation. For dialing instructions in English, please press 1.
日本語での番号案内.
Please wait. The call is being transferred.
Possibly at our hotel. Peter worked.
Did you call a kitchen?
To bring you amenities based on his breakthrough formulas. From
pseudo.
A signature massaging bath bar.
To it's a felony to make harassing calls.
If you'd like firm reservations or review your account information online, please visit our website at www.
Hey guys, did you know that pretexting is a felony?
Pretexting.
Once again, that website address.
Not according to our lawyers, our pot smoking lawyers.
Our normal business hours are Monday through Thursday, 8 a.m. to 10 p.m. Eastern Time. And on Fridays and Saturdays,
I think you're cutting out, Roxy.
Yeah.
Am I?
Thank
you. You are for me.
Did you guys know that recording a call is a felony?
Wow, did they hang up on us? What the hell?
Maybe.
That's not
right. Did you know that assuming someone is something that they're not is a felony?
Aloha, and thank you for calling the Grand Waikiki Institute. Please wait while we transfer you to the operator.
Oh, did you know that filing a report with the police that's not real is a felony?
Did you know that calling a hotel is a felony?
Hello, it's the operator. This is Abe.
Hello?
Hey, Abe?
Oh.
Abe, I need to ask you something first. Abe, did you know that eating waffles for breakfast is a felony?
I'm sorry, sir?
Did you know eating waffles for breakfast is a felony?
Too much butter is
sure
a
about that
double
on this
felony.
State, though.
Just give us the front desk, retard. Come on.
Mahalo.
The hotel features 100.
Mahalo.
Did he say
okay. Mahalo? Yeah, he said Mahalo. You guys take this. I don't want it.
Okay,
I'll
do it. I'll do it.
Okay,
okay?
You
I'll
can.
Okay.
Do it, Roxy. Do it. Do it.
Hi, Dark Stranger.
You know you
shout
want
out.
It.
And Dark Stranger's
like dark
cat.
Just little sheep. No, it's a sheep. It's a little stuffed sheep.
No, it's a real one.
It's like a cat. Oh.
It's a sheep, right?
Oh, hi. This is Stacy. Are you at the front desk?
Yes, I am.
Okay, well, my son brought with him, I went down to the pool, and I came back up here, and it turns out my son, while I was gone, inflated an indoor kiddie pool, and there's just, like, water everywhere now. I asked the little brat if he could come down to the pool, but he said no, and this is just a big prank that he pulled, and we're sorry.
Okay, what room are you in?
Hang on a second. My son's gonna have to talk to you, because it's his problem. He's gonna have to face the music here.
Okay.
Don't charge us for this, okay? But kind of, like, scare him a little and yell at him. You just act really mad.
Okay.
Okay, hold on.
What room are you in, though?
I'm in 12. I'm in 208.
I'm sorry?
I'm in 208.
208?
Yeah. Hold on. Yeah, just... Billy.
Do I really have to say it?
Yes. You need to tell her what happened.
She'll yell at me.
Well, if that's what happens, that's what happens.
Just don't hit me again.
Okay.
I'll tell her if you don't hit me.
Come on. Son, face the music. Don't cry.
Hello?
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
I did something bad.
Okay, what did you do?
When my mom was down drinking margaritas, I filled up one of those inflatable pools and made mess everywhere, and I ruined the phone, I ruined the bed, I ruined some other things, and I didn't mean to.
So is the carpet all wet?
The carpet's all wet. I mean, I put some sand down, but that didn't really help. I just...
Okay, and what room are you in?
My mom said not to tell you that, because if I told you that, then you would charge us.
Well, the only thing is that, you know, if the water leaks through the flooring, and goes down to the next room.
I mean, it was only four foot. I mean, it's not that much. I mean, let me get the box. The box says it holds 50 gallons of water, but I think I only put like 40 something.
Even if it was like 5 gallons of water, if you put it...
Oh, well, it's 40,
it soaks through the... Yeah, if it soaks through the carpet and through the mat in the carpet...
I mean, it's gone. The door is that bad.
Okay, well, if they hear of any problems in the rooms below you, I'm sure they're going to trace it to your room.
Am I going to get in trouble?
You might. You shouldn't do stuff like that because, you know, it could cost your mom quite a bit of money if it goes down to the next room.
She says it costs money?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it will if that leak goes all the way down to the next room.
Amy, okay, Amy, she's told her manager.
Oh, my
okay,
God.
Let me find out what's going on.
In yeah, you shouldn't do stuff like that because, you know, it affects other people and it may cause a lot of damage.
Yeah, that's right.
Because especially if the moisture stays in the carpet and it's not, you know, vacuumed up, it may get moldy and we'd have to replace the carpet.
Well, we're not going to do that. I just wanted you to yell at him, but we're just going to check out early, just leave without...
It's just so that he knows the consequences because, you know, if he thinks it's just in your room, it's not because it'll go through the, you know, the padding and everything.
Okay, it's on my husband's credit card, so hang on a second. Honey, come talk, tell this lady not to try your card. Hello?
Oh, hello? Sorry, I was spacing out. I'm really high right now. What can I help you with, ma'am? Hello, ma'am?
Hello?
Yes, hello, I'm sorry. I was off in another world.
Has the carpet, I mean, is it still kind of soppy?
The carpet? Oh, yeah. I mean, it was a pool. It was 8 feet in diameter and like 3 feet tall. And it was completely full.
Okay, we filled it up. If you give me your room number, we can send housekeeping up there with a vacuum to vacuum that carpet up.
Oh, I mean, it's more than a vacuum. The thing is, there's about 3 inches of water, standing water, in the room. And if we open our door, it's all going to come out into the hallway. It's pretty much like a pool inside the room.
Uh-huh. Oh, my.
So, I mean, it's awesome for the kids.
Yeah, we should have somebody bring a wet vac up there to vacuum it.
Can they come in the window? Because the door is... If we open the door, it's just all going to come out, and that'll ruin my kids' fun.
Okay, when I call the housekeeper to come up, I'll let them know that before they open the door, they should be putting some kind of something by the door so that the water doesn't rush out.
Yeah, something like, I don't know, something that holds about 100 gallons of water.
Yeah.
Yeah, about 30 trash bags should do it, because it's all just going to come gushing out. And we've still got the water running in the bathtub, and it's overflowing onto the floor, so it just keeps getting deeper and deeper.
What room are you in?
Oh, I don't know. My wife got the room, and we can't open the door. I can't, like, go out there.
What is your last name?
Hey,
The thing is, the water is flowing onto the floor right now. It's getting deeper and deeper and deeper. And we can't turn off the bath faucet because my son broke the knobs, the little bastard. Mm-hmm. He broke the knobs, both the knobs in the bathtub.
That's my fault.
Okay, well...
Shut the fuck up,
can you say your last name?
I'm sorry, what?
Ma'am,
what is your last name?
I just picked up the phone here. Oh,
well, I don't know if it's under our name or my wife's ex-husband's name. Here, to talk to her. Cause
ma'am, I just picked up the other phone because... Yeah, because he needs...
Okay, can I get your last name?
Ma'am, this is impossible. My husband got really, really high, so This is kind of impossible right now, and I would appreciate it if you would just forget that this happened. We're going to cancel our credit card and just check out right now.
That's fine.
Okay, yeah, just forget it. And you have us as paying cash, right? I mean, we came in here and we just paid cash. And
I don't have your room number or your name.
Oh, perfect. Perfect. Okay. All right. Can you transfer us to room 210? There are. We need to talk to them. Make sure they're not affected by this.
Okay. Do you know who the people are in 210?
Well, they're on the same floor. I don't want them to be affected by this.
No, we don't, because we can't just transfer calls unless you know who the person is.
Oh, ma'am, this is Pizza Hut, and they called us and. You know, we need to deliver pizza, but they've never told us their name.
My son's being stupid. Just, we met them downstairs at the pool. And I really, really need to get a hold of them. This is really important, because otherwise this is going to start affecting them. They're going to complain to you. Just transfer me to 210. Please.
I cannot do that. It's not something that we do.
Ma'am, I just need to let you know something. The water has now reached the point to where the water is going inside the receptacles, you know, where you plug things in, and it's starting to spark and smoke a little. And that's unacceptable, because that could electrocute us.
And yeah, that we shouldn't really have to deal with.
Well, if you don't tell me what room you're in, I can't get you help.
You need to fix your hotel.
Can you just shut off the power to the third floor?
Now you're on the third floor and not the second floor?
Oh, whatever floor we're on. I don't know. I didn't get the room.
I don't know if you don't tell me, sir.
Ma'am, well, I don't know. Talk to my wife.
We're in 208. We need to speak to 210. It's really important.
Are you in Ali'i 208?
Yes.
I don't show anyone in that room.
Well, good. You'll never catch us.
We're squatters, ma'am.
Haha, bye.
LOL.
Wow,
she totally didn't get mad at all.
Yeah, she's just like, oh, that's okay. Go ahead, cancel your credit card.
Hello.
Oh, hello, sir. You guys, do you guys have a swimming pool here?
No.
At the hotel? Huh? Sir?
We have no swimming pool.
Okay, see, my son had this bright idea because you don't have a swimming pool.
No, he
put a swimming pool in the room. He put one of those inflatable.
No.
Yes. Yes, he did. My son put a pool inside the room, a kiddie pool. And it's kind of leaking.
We don't have a swimming pool, okay?
Sir, you're not listening to me. I'm already staying there. And my son, my bastard son, he put a swimming pool in the room.
Which room number? Huh?
He put a swimming pool in the room.
But which room is there? Stay.
Sir, are you foreign?
Huh?
Are you a foreigner?
Yeah, but you know, I do not rent the room. How your son is in his swimming pool, you know?
My son put a swimming pool inside the room.
Ma'am, I do not rent the room, you know.
So okay, hang on. You want to talk to my son? Go. Hold on. Yell at my son. Hold on. Just make sure you yell at him, or he's not going to learn.
Hello?
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 Which room you are in? Which room you are in?
Hola, ¿cómo estás? ¿Cómo estás? ¿Cómo estás?
No Spanish. You know the English only, you know. But the, you know, you rent the room here in Lark Motel?
Large motel, L-A-R-K, large motel, sir. Hola, ¿cómo estás? Me llamo Fred.
No, but you rent the room. Which room you rent? Because I do not rent the room here, you know. Nobody's coming.
Room?
Your mom said my friend rent the room.
Room?
Maybe another motel, you know, I'm telling you.
Room 4... Room 2,
no? We have nothing customer here in room number 4, number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, nothing.
Okay.
Okay.
Aquí. Hola, ¿cómo estás?
See, I have breaking news. Can you play the breaking news music?
I do not have breaking news music. Hold on, hold on, hold on.
Wait, Akison, can you make some breaking news music? Okay, the breaking news, and I apologize, Lee, I don't want to turn your show into last night's phone show, but it appears that phonewinners.com is down for some reason. Like, it doesn't exist anymore. What happened to their website?
What?
What?
Phonewinners. Phonewinners with an S. It's not loading for me. Maybe I'm having internet problems here. But.
It's probably because he's been refreshing your page.
He ate what? Up all his own bandwidth.
And so, no, he's been refreshing. Wait. He crashed your internet, Arby. He crashed your internet.
Maybe he ran out of bandwidth on his home internet account.
Wait. Let me see if it loads for me. Oh, my God. It's not loading. All my pictures gone.
Oh, poor Roxy. You had a feature story on there.
I know. Oh, my God.
All right. Well, I just wanted to let people know. Linear actually
Wait. No. Don't blame this on Linear. You were sitting there refreshing their page.
No. Linear just messaged me and told me that it was broken for some reason.
Sporty Board just said, I went to phonewinnerswithaz.com and it's working for me.
Guys.
Oh, yeah, if people want to go to phonewinnerswithaz, it's there.
Yes, they have a mirror site.
What was that, Roxy?
They have a mirror site. Phonewinners.com. That's with the Z, everyone. I wonder what could have happened. Obviously, somebody got the word that you know, something was going on there. And they didn't like it, and they... I don't know. It's probably just their internet connection.
Yeah, probably. I'm sure it'll be right back.
Akison got scared.
Yeah.
Akison got scared.
Akison left. What, is Akison gone?
RBCP, did you hack their website?
No.
Is that why it's down?
That's crazy talk. I don't hack things. I have nothing to do with this.
Did you sneak in their window with an axe and hack for their server?
Maybe.
Oh,
okay.
Really? Maybe?
I didn't know my breaking news was going to turn into accusations against me.
Oh, okay, it wasn't you. Actually, no. It could have been a variety of people. Who knows? Who knows? It could have been anyone. But, I mean, we've got hundreds of phone losers, and they've only got like 4 phone winners. So, it could have
Roxy,
been
two.
Anyway.
Two.
As long as we're talking about this, can I ask you a question, Roxy? Have you gotten any calls today that begs people to go to their URL?
No, so far I haven't gotten any.
That's really strange.
You know,
I don't understand
weird.
Why not. It seems like we weren't getting any on my show around the end of last night.
You know what's weird is usually they call me with like an automated message or an automatic message. It's not really them calling me. It's just some recording.
Dionis says we need to get Detective Cardo on the case. He can find out the truth.
Shit. Something's going on.
I'm scared. I'm going to hang up, too. I'm going to be like Akison.
Brad, without phone winners...
I need Akison to hold me.
Where are we going to get all of our content from?
I don't know. They're the ones that pioneered Craigslist ads for us.
That's it. I'm gonna create an alter ego and start harassing you, RBCP.
Something's
Thank
up.
Thank you.
Guys.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Guys, something is up. Do you think Harry died?
What's that?
Do you think Harry died?
Oh, let's hope not, because you know the world needs him.
Maybe his mother grounded him.
maybe he went to a Civil War reenactment and got blown up.
Yeah, probably. Probably like somebody shot him with a cannon.
This should be entertaining. Unknown number calling.
Finally.
Hello, unknown caller. Hello, unknown caller. Oh my God, they're ruining our show by not talking.
Damn, I was hoping to be able to.
Oh, shh, he's saying something.
Sorry. Hello.
They're echoing us.
You're on the air.
Wait, this is priceless. Ooh, I heard a tiny chat bloop.
Oh, that might have been me. Sorry.
Turn your fucking sounds off. Hi, Harry. How are you doing? Sorry about your website.
The world needs him.
Sorry about your website, Harry. You see, that's the problem with these guys. They don't talk. They just hide, and they don't talk.
And that's fake.
That, you know,
those
I wish,
crazy phone winners.
You know, like, what we used to do, remember, Brad, what we used to do is actually call in with content and actually trick other places into
thinking.
Oh, yeah,
like the AM radio stations
and
that.
You know, make them think that we're legitimate callers. And then go in with Cactus.
Hello?
Yeah, let's just listen to ourselves talk again. That's what they're doing.
Or we could call them Motel 6.
Damn, you guys are boring. No wonder nobody calls your bridge. I only called the bridge once. I mean, wow. Oh, and get this, guys. Get this. They claim they're going to come meet me.
Oh, yeah, they're coming down to get you. Joe M. from Pennsylvania is coming to get you.
First of all.
So be ready for rape tonight while you sleep.
Okay. Number problem number one. They don't have money to come down here. That's problem number one.
No, he's got $3,000 in cash.
Well,
sitting on his server.
That's true, but
because we're certain that thing is in Harry's house, just like he claims.
Okay, problem number one. They're coming down to get me with money they don't have from the Northeast. I know from experience, flights from the Northeast are not cheap. Okay, it's not going to be $50. Second of all, pseudo just dropped. Second of all, number two.
More show for me.
They don't know where I am.
Pseudo drops a lot. Maybe she's getting DOSed again.
I hope not. No, but they don't even know where I am. The name and address that they allegedly have is not even mine. Hello, 484 number.
Hello.
How are you?
How's it going?
Pretty
hey, baby.
Good. Who is this?
Hello.
Hello. This is a recording from phonewinners.com.
What's my caller ID show?
It shows 484-240-4051. Very, very clever.
Awesome.
Very clever. You know how to spoof
Hello?
A call.
Yeah, I know. I'm pretty smart.
Yeah. All right. Was that all you had to say, sir? We've got some prank calls to do.
I just wanted to add some actual entertainment to the show, because so far I'm fucking bored.
Ah, thank you. Thanks.
That's
what do you,
so mean.
What do you want to do,
not
sir?
Not even one whole show.
You right. know, we have feelings, sir.
Sir, yeah. we actually have to get on with the show, so unless you say something interesting in the next 30 seconds... Ah, Andy dropped.
Is right. this one of them?
Most likely. I mean,
no,
he didn't...
Roxy's just it's assuming 4-8-4. Everyone that calls in. They're
it's
not gonna
it's
call
him.
In.
I mean, who else would spoof their number? Come on. They're the only ones that are scared.
Sorry, I missed most of that. I was actually... My internet connection was...
Motel 6 for Milano. This is Ruth. How may I help you?
Could we have room 131?
And the occupant name?
Why do you sound like crap?
Hello, ma'am. Are you having trouble with your phone?
I'm sorry. We it would have been pointless. Well, because we couldn't hear. She was asking for the name too.
Oh, well, I'm
well, you should have just said that one of your friends is staying with their friend, so you don't know what name the room is in.
You do it, Sudo.
Okay. What room number?
Any.
Okay.
Jeez, Brad, thanks for reminding them to call. Now they're mobbing me.
Who's
they're mobbing?
No, I'm just kidding. Called like once. No, they do keep calling.
Don't pretend that call was the phone winners. It's more hilarious if you don't get a single call from them tonight.
Okay. Well, I don't know who it was, but whoever it was.
Well, I mean,
really
it could have
boring.
Been them, but I don't know.
They were really boring. Where's Rob? Where's Rob?
Oh, yeah, where the hell is Rob?
Rob, you're late for the show.
He's in bed.
Why is he in bed, Pseudo?
I tucked him in. He was tired.
That doesn't make any sense.
Your party is not answering. Please try your call later.
Was that Motel 6?
We're sorry, but your call will now be disconnected. 073P.
Did you see I posted another one?
Little message. Yeah, I got it. That was an interesting little message. It was very polite.
Hello, and thank you for calling Motel 6 Springfield. If you know the room number of the guest,
you're sorry, I did karaoke tonight. I'm still singing.
I still think they're going to jump out at DEFCON and just, like, surprise Brad after months of silence with a bad kiss.
Good evening. Thank you for choosing Motel 6, Springfield, Illinois. This is David. May I help you?
Oh, David, you sound really bored. Sorry. Go ahead.
Hi,
go
ahead. I need a room 210, please.
What's the name of the guest?
You know, it's actually my friend staying with a group of her friends, so I don't know whose room the name is.
Cannot connect you to a room without the name of the guest. I'm very sorry.
Why are you being rude? My friend is there. I just don't
know
whose name
the room is. That is our policy. We do not connect calls to rooms without the name of the guests.
Can I speak to your manager, please? Can I speak to your manager?
He'll be here at 7 o'clock in the morning, ma'am.
Okay, well, what's his name?
His name is Sabash. His last name is
Sabash.
Are you
Sabash? Backside?
I'm sorry?
His name's Sabash Backside?
His name is Sabash Bhattai, Bhattie.
Oh, sir, excuse me. I have to interrupt here, but you're being insanely rude and boring.
Okay, well, I'm sorry. Big booted and boring. You
yeah,
folks have a nice
ass,
night.
Sir.
And stuff.
I'm going to call that guy back.
Brought to you by phonewinners.com.
Hello, and thank you for calling.
Illinois is really, you know, they really follow that policy of knowing the last name.
I'm sorry, guys. This show is unfunny.
Oh, come on. Like, fun shows everything.
Good evening.
Funny.
Thank you for choosing Motel 6, Springfield, Illinois. This is David. May I help you?
Okay, David. Yes,
David,
you can
what?
Help me. I need to talk to Stacy Winters. I don't know which room she's in, because she's with her friends.
Well, let me see if she's registered.
If you're going to be a fucking idiot and not transfer me. Ugh.
I don't have a Stacy Winters registered.
You don't,
I'm sorry.
She's staying with her friend. She's staying with her friend Michelle, but I don't know Michelle's last name. But they told us it was room 131.
This is what happens when they hire.
Well,
a
minute ago you told me it was room 210.
Oh, was it 210?
But you guys have a nice evening. If you can't tell me the guest name.
Right here.
Hello, and thank you for calling Motel 6 St. Louis North.
Your boner's wiggle, I don't trust in a while.
If you are calling, please enter it at any time. For directions to the motel, please press 1. For reservations, please press 2. For the front desk, please
press
3. Or hold on the line for further assistance.
Wow. I'm just going to let them talk to each other. Okay, Brad.
Hello?
Oh, they hung up. Bastards.
Who's yelling at me? Why did I get yelled at?
Because you were pressing the button and it hurt my ears.
I didn't push
Thanks
a button.
Thanks for calling myself. Lorena speaking. How may I help you?
Yeah, Lorena, I need room 132 right now. Hurry.
Excuse me?
Excuse you. Excuse
Hello?
You. Hello, 132. Chop chop. Let's go. Little skank.
I like the name Loretta.
See, that's not nice. You shouldn't be like that. She's just doing her job, man.
She's not being very, like, snappy with it. 132, snap, snap.
Roxy only has a few hours left to live anyways.
Is there a man there that I can talk to?
Oh, they might let her live after they rape her.
Is there a man there?
It's not rape as long as they yell surprise first.
Alright, phone ringers, save this call.
Hello, what are you doing? Hey, Rocky, you will not think of the goldfish. What are you doing? You got Jimmy Changa and a Guatemalan on your ass now, bitch.
I love this
what
guy.
What you got to be stupid, Brad Gunther? Your mom was a chihuahua and your father smelled of tequila. I shit all over you, you Mexican. And Brad Gunther, what are you going to do? You going to try to hack for me at this time? I'm going to shit all over you. I'm going to get a bag of peach and put it in cushion and smash it into your face.
Let's do a prank call with this guy.
And I'm going to smash you with
the motel lady.
Let's just start adding people's numbers to the song.
Dang it. The motel lady hung up. All right. I've got something else we're gonna do.
I don't know why she didn't stay on for that guy. That guy's awesome.
No, that guy was awesome.
He needs to be a co-host here. He's more exciting than me.
And me.
Well, yeah.
Especially you, Aikson. Fuck you.
Yeah, especially.
All right, guys. We're gonna get something. We're gonna get a random person in on this shit. Hold on.
I have a feeling I'm going to wake up tomorrow with, like, someone holding a bag of piss above my head.
Let's hope.
All right, this guy had his phone stolen, so let's help him out.
Ooh, let's call Lost and Found on
Craig. While your party is reached.
Howdy.
Yeah, howdy. What the fuck was that music?
Oh, where?
On your phone, dude. When I called it, you know what? Never mind. You said your phone was stolen? Hello?
This is Alex.
Yeah. Well, was Byron's phone stolen?
Who is this?
This is Stacy.
Stacy, do you know Stacy?
Hey, did you pick up Byron's phone for him? Of course he's going to lie to you.
Oh, no. This is Byron's phone.
Yeah, let me talk to Byron, motherfucker.
Dude, I don't know who this is, but she's tripping me out. Yeah. It's Stacy.
Hurry the fuck up, dude.
Who the hell is this?
Hurry the fuck up and give me to Byron. This isn't even your phone. Fuck off.
Oh my god, dude. I don't know who this is. She's like, what's
oh, they hung up on me. Who wants to be my friend?
I love how amazed he was.
Yeah, he's
music
like,
while your party is reached.
Oh god.
Oh yes, it's the song again. I love this song so much.
Yeah, yeah. Hello?
Hey, Byron?
Hey. Yeah?
Byron. Is this Byron?
America. This is Byron.
Oh my god, finally. What the fuck?
Or I ignored you. But who is this?
This is Stacy.
Make the funny message now. I don't like those dull ones, they're boring. So let me use stuff and I'll try and get back to you as soon as I can.
I'm calling you on my other line, so you're gonna get this in a voicemail. That's awesome.
Did she just call me and, like, leave me a voicemail at the same time?
No. I was calling you on two different lines so I can hear... So you'll actually get this as a voicemail later so you can reminisce over our times together. What's up, motherfucker?
What's up? Who is this?
Stacy, I told you, like, four times already. What the fuck? Clean the shit out of your ears.
No, my friend answered the phone. He's kind of... He's in a delicate state right now.
Oh, what happened? Did his dog die?
No, he smoked a little bit of something, and now he's a little childish.
Who the hell is that?
I don't know, Alex. Quit asking me.
Tell him it's Stacy.
It's Stacy. He wants to know from where.
It's just fucking Stacy. Tell him it's just fucking Stacy.
Okay, thank you. The voicemail just ended.
That's awesome.
Stacy from where?
Just tell him it's fucking Stacy.
I'm sorry, your recording time has expired. To send this message now, press pound.
Okay,
to replay your message, press 4-4. For additional options, press **. To send this message now, press pound. Enter a telephone number where you can
the
be reached.
Thing is I
press
can't
1.
Hang up on it
to continue recording at this point, press 3. To replay
yeah,
your message, press
a hot dog,
4.
Alex.
To end this call, press *9. For additional options, press **.
Wow. Are you there?
To send this message
oh
now,
my God,
press
I'll
call
you
yeah,
back.
To enter a telephone number where you can be...
It was like each, like the box for his number... There were two boxes on top of each other. I had to press the hang-up button twice.
That's weird.
That was so weird. What was that?
Were you leaving him a message while you were talking to him?
Yes, it was weird.
So he's going to hear his own voice?
Yes.
Wait, how's that possible? You can't dial the same number.
I don't know. Somehow I dialed it twice. I, like, dialed it and then I answered it.
Fucking Skype.
Brad, you should ask him if he has any weed left over, because you want to smoke some.
Hey, it's Byron. I'm currently on a trip around America, so I probably just need to call my phone with that because it's hard to turn the phone
up. Fuck you, Byron. Fuck you.
He's bragging. He's bragging that he's on a trip around the Americas.
Hello, Byron. Why aren't you answering my calls anymore? I thought we were best friends.
I'm trying to hear calls. My phone's being stupid. All right, this is Stacy from where?
Oh, hang on. My brother wants to talk to you. Hold on.
Hey. Yeah. Hey. This is Kevin, and I heard you you guys have weed there, and I need to know how much, because I'd like to come by and get some.
Get some what?
Get some weed. I want to buy some weed from you guys, because I hear you have a lot of weed there.
Oh, yeah, we've got so much. We don't actually have any.
that's kind of a lie, because Stacy told me you have some, and if I get there and there's not weed, we're going to have problems.
Oh, yeah. Lots of problems. Hey, let me tell you how many problems we're going to have. There's going to be one problem. I'm sorry, my friend is high. He smoked all of the weed. Those pounds
and
pounds of
it. I don't believe that at all. And I want some weed. And give me your address now.
Dude,
the problem is
with
you sucking my dick. Alex, quit. Oh, where do you live?
Byron, we have your address already.
Hello?
Yeah, hello. We have your address already. Go ahead, Kevin. We have your address.
Hello?
Yeah, we have
Oh, Kevin.
Your
I'm
address.
Kevin. Okay, yeah, yes. I get it now. Hi.
Okay. I see everybody's forgetting who they are. Where do you people live?
But my name really is Kevin. I don't know why you're not believing that, jerk.
I'm such a jerk. God damn me.
I hate how
where do you guys live?
We're not telling you. You're a bunch of drug addicts.
Oh, yeah.
Like you're going to come shoot us up or some
I've been,
shit.
I've been smoking some LSD and dropping some marijuanas lately.
Oh, okay. My God. No, I've heard about people
shooting
that
up a little bit of cocaine.
We're in Georgia, but we're going to come up there and... we're going to come up there and... get some weed from you right now.
Byron?
You're in Georgia?
Byron, listen. Byron.
Okay.
I need you...
Yeah?
I need you to set off the fire alarms.
The fire alarms?
Yes. Use your toilet lid, maybe. Or a heavy object and just bash the top of it open. It's okay. A test. It's all right. I'm with the fire company.
Is it kind of like the signal or something?
Yeah, yeah.
It's
everything's
totally okay.
Everything's fine.
It's okay because you're high and your insurance will pay for it. Just do it. We're trying to help you, bro. Hello?
He went to do it.
I think Byron's lost in a pot-smoking stupor right now.
Yeah, sounds like it.
My friend is high. Whatever. You're high, dude. Oh, he hung up.
Your mom's high.
You're high. You are probably high.
You're higher.
Actually. Yeah, I am.
I win.
I'm high on life, baby. Kindy. That's her name. Kindy.
What are we calling?
Her name's Kindy.
What are we calling? What are we calling?
It's a lady.
Oh, sorry.
Her name's Kindy.
And hey, can we just end the show now? I'm bored.
No.
Okay.
Hey, it's off. You got my voicemail because I'm probably ignoring you to play video games, or I'm at work and actually busy. So I guess if you want, just leave a message and I'll try to get back to you.
Hi, Kindy. We just want to let you know that we hacked into your Facebook, so you'll be getting tons of spam. Bye.
Oh, well. Roxy, that wasn't nice.
Sorry. Hello, 416 number.
Yo. Hey, is this Gummy Bear and Juliet?
Gummy Bear?
I'm Gummy Bear.
Gummy Bear.
Is it clear?
Oh, see, like a giant moth on you.
Call some Southern Hotel.
Hey, Byron?
Yeah?
Byron, why are you calling us back?
I don't know. They probably might know you.
Because he's a dick, that's why.
Oh, yeah. Humongous.
Wait, Byron's calling us from Canada?
No. Byron is a 912 number.
Oh, okay. Skype confuses me. I don't get it.
I know who this 416 guy is, but this 912 guy is Byron, who just won't leave us alone. Stop harassing us.
I'm a 416 person.
Excuse me. Stop harassing me. I'm going to report you.
Okay. Well, do we know you guys somehow? Because we've met like a lot of people recently.
Yeah, because you've been traveling the world or some shit.
He's been traveling the states. Is that what he said?
No, it says that on my voicemail, Alex. Yeah.
God, you guys are retarded. Go. You need to smoke less weed. Okay, we're gonna come over and take care of the weed situation for you and smoke.
It's ruining your life, man.
Yeah, you need to give it up.
I actually don't smoke any weed. It's my friend that smokes. He's like a demon or something. He's always got a joint in his mouth.
You're a demon. Bye. Hey, Magico. How are you?
How's it going?
Pretty good. Sorry, we were just in the middle of that call there, but that guy was getting really kind of crazy.
Yeah, he smoked a little too much, I think.
Yeah, but he claims that his friend smoked too much.
Yeah, I was a contact guy. He didn't know.
Well, name a city. You want Baltimore? Baltimore's pretty ghetto. Detroit?
There's a difference in doing coke and smelling it.
Detroit, you want Detroit, Michigan? Is that a good motel place? Let's do Detroit.
Detroit, Michigan? Well, what kind of motel is it? Like a Motel 8?
I don't think they have hotels there.
Make it like a dive motel.
I want to do a skanky motel.
Dark Stranger
says... like a really rich... Oh, the acrobats like to swing from chandeliers.
Dark Stranger says that Flint, Michigan is the most happening place in Michigan.
Okay.
Well,
that's not Detroit exactly, I guess.
It's close enough. All right, so you want to do your circus thing.
Yeah.
I'm
on 75, and they're all waiting, and they're tired, and they need to sleep.
All right, so Super 8, Red Roof Inn, Holiday Inn Express, Motel 6, Comfort Inn, Baymont Inn. Which one sounds good to you?
Yeah, Motel 8.
Alright, that would be Super 8. Alright, here we go. Save my show. Actually, that last guy was pretty funny. But we have 7 minutes left, so we gotta do something.
Super 8 Miller Road, may I help you?
How's it going tonight? This is... I'm just coming down 75. I'm looking for a place to sleep. I need about, probably 15 rooms all on the same floor. Can you accommodate?
How many rooms?
I need, 15 rooms. You guys accept animals, right?
Yes, but we don't have right now
15 rooms. I got ping-pong playing parrots. They need their own room.
Uh-huh. We don't have 15 rooms.
Don't have 15. How many rooms do you have? Because I got like a traveling circus, and I need to put some people away for the night. And you know, there's like acrobats that need to practice. So I hope you have a lot of, a lot of parking lot.
Oh yes, we do have a parking lot, but we have only two double beds.
Parking lot.
And
something could sleep in the trailer. We could just leave them out. Just rent like some of the rooms, and we'll bring them down some ice buckets.
We have only two double beds and four single bedroom.
How many people do you think you could get in one of those rooms? Do you think about eight?
Yes, eight.
It's okay. They don't mind sleeping together.
Uh-huh.
I figure we could put like the bearded lady and the elephant man in one room. They'll probably fit. So you got like four rooms?
Four singles and two doubles. That's all.
Four singles and... How many people can fit in the room?
Maximum 12.
Can we leave the birds down in the lobby for the night?
No.
They make a lot of noise. They just squawk a bit. We just tend to yell at them and they quiet down.
No, sir. We do not allow.
I don't want to go back and tell a bunch of clowns that they don't have no place to sleep. Like, there's nothing you can do. Like, I could, you know, slip you something. I'll be sure like one of them has some paraphernalia.
Mm-hmm. No, we cannot allow that.
I mean, this could be a big career move for you. I mean, you get me some rooms and get these people here, you know, we could do some business.
No, sir, we cannot, because our system do not cannot allow that.
Is there room in the parking lot? Could we just, like, leave one of the trailers there and they could make a makeshift? Like, we could borrow some pillows?
No, sir.
What about blankets? Even the dirty ones, like the ones that haven't been washed yet by the maid, there's probably some backups or spares, right?
No. Mm-hmm.
Well, how many people can I get in the room?
Maximum 14 people.
14 people in one room, so that and you have four beds. How much room would be left if we get a bunch of those throwaway beds? Because this one guy, it's like a mermaid. She needs a pool all the time. It's about probably only like 6 feet wide, about 3 feet deep, and I figure we can just run holes from the room next door and fill it up pretty quick. Last time it busted, and it kind of, you know, flooded the whole floor and stuff, so we got cleaned up right away with a bunch of towels. And
no, sir, we don't have, we cannot allow more than 14 people.
No, we're not going to have 14 people. There's only going to be, like, probably three people, like I was, and the birds and the ping-pong-playing parrot and the tecto-playing rooster. I mean, you could put the birds down in the lobby. It'd probably attract more visitors.
No, sir. We don't have extra linen.
Okay, I'll just talk to my friend there and see if he has any room. Could you transfer me over to room 108, please?
108?
Yes, that's it. 108.
No, 108 is not occupied.
He said he's in one. Hold on, let me see if I wrote it down. 108. They said they had 108, 112. Is there a Smith in the 112?
Which?
And 112. He wrote down 108 through 112 because he said they had to get a few rooms.
Name?
Could you tell me who's staying in 112? I just want to make sure it's my friend there.
Name?
Sorry, what was it? Lynn?
Name? What's the name of a friend?
It's supposed to be Lynn. He's going to register a few rooms. I have no idea who's staying in which room. That's what I'm trying to figure out, to see if they have any more room for everybody else. Because you said 14 people per room. If they have some room left, because they rented them this morning.
No, sir, it's not
Who rented the room this morning? Did anybody rent? Like, was there like a John Smith that rented the room this morning, or a Bill Pryor?
In 112? What?
Fire, OMG.
Hello? Fire, fire, oh my god.
That's what I yell when
fire.
I get really bored.
Fire.
Don't pay any attention to me.
Bomb.
Oh. Don't yell bomb, you idiot. What are you doing, Roxy?
Nothing.
You're insane.
Yep, I'm insane and the show's over.
Yay, I can hang up now.
Okay, I guess, if you want to.
Oh, no, I don't really want to hang up. I would like to mention that phonewinners.com has just been up and down the entire show. It keeps going offline, then it takes forever to load.
I find that really odd.
Yeah, I don't understand. It's weird.
I thought they were like eight actors.
Yeah,
oh,
me too.
Magico left. Bye, Magico. Hey, Tabachi, thanks for coming to the ass end of my show. How are you? Tabachi, we have 45 seconds left in the outro. Say something.
You didn't load up the new outro that I made for you?
I didn't have a chance to use it. You said it was long.
It's not long. It's just double.
I was just going to use it for, like, in-between
shit
or
anything.
I see. Like technical difficulties. Phonewinners with a Z.com.
Yeah, Facebook.com/TheSamantha.
HackTheRadio.com/FunShow. Go download all my shit and shit. And the after show starts now.
There's an after show?
Yeah, very short.